Yes, welcome back to World of Sport. Well, today's small oval race meeting at Wimbledon is featured next. Remembering the big hot rod race, the most valuable ever as far as the winner is concerned for the Winter National Gold Cup, with the winner taking away £2,000, is at 3:20. But now we can look first at the Facey Leisure Silver Awards for Superstox. The Superstox are the kind of machines you wouldn't see out on the roads because they are custom-built for racing around these small circuits. They're very powerfully engined and yet very simple in design. They're constructed on the two lateral girders, or straight-throughs as they're called. Formidable bumpers are affixed fore and aft, and the drivers sit amidships in cabs strengthened with roll cages. Well, now the engine specifications have changed since we last saw these on the track, and Nigel King, our commentator, can enlighten us.
Well, yes, they have, and once again, the object of the exercise is to produce competitive racing at a reasonable cost. Since the summer, the Superstox have been fitted with the Ford Pinto engine, which, in terms of road machinery, is the 2-litre engine from the Ford Sierra. It has to be in standard running gear, that's to say, you can't put on fancy carburettors. You can put any cam you like, but there's no turbocharging, no supercharging, and the object of the exercise, as I said, is to produce a lot of power and to try and save some money. Well, who's going to win? Well, this man's right on form here. A couple of weeks ago, he won the English Championship, has a reputation for going well at Wimbledon. Blue grade driver, 407, Jim Davey. Amongst the stars, a man who often turns in a really good performance, number 18, Mark Eaton. He's starting on the front row of the red tops and must be in with a good chance. 40 laps to come then. Already problems down the far end, as you can see. And one after the other, they pile in. Dave Willis in 665 isn't going to get out of that in a hurry. Well and truly trapped in there. The flag marshal just checking that everyone's okay. But the majority of the rest of them seem to get clear and are back and running. So apart from that little congestion on the outside of the turn there, there seems to be a particularly wet spot. One or two drifting about at the top end. Well, that's Dave Willis just scrambled out, and that's the end of the race for him. Oh, and there's 18. That's a turn up for the book. Mark Eaton starting from the front of the stars. We thought he might go well, but he's completed just one lap. Some of the front runners there, a yellow top and a star man beginning to catch up. Once again, a little settling down period seems to be par for the course. The track is pretty dry. There's a fair amount of grip. They just want to take things nice and easy first of all. Derek Brundle in 408, we saw there, the yellow grey driver. Start to pick up some places for you now. In fact, it was 408 there, was the leader. 95 is in second place. That's David Webb. And 334 is currently third. So we got 408 still sitting there. Laps gone, yellow top, and we've got problems. In fact, now the control car has just swung onto the track. There's a pile up on down on the bottom bend in the center of your picture. The control car has come on, the yellow flag has come out. That means the drivers must now maintain the positions that they are currently in. The object of the exercise is to try and keep the race rolling whilst they deal with an injured driver. Usually it may be that in fact we can get the driver out quickly and the race can resume without having to go through the formalities of actually completely bringing the whole thing to a stop and starting again. There's the driver. I can't tell you who it is, I'm afraid, from that particular shot. The car is a little sick in there on the outside of the track. I think it's 42, Barry Keane. But the race is now back on. The control car has pulled off. The driver has got to safety. That little breather while the control car was on allowed them to get the driver out onto the Greyhound track, and we continue. Six laps have gone. 408 is still the leader. Derek Brundle from Tolworth in Surrey. There's 407, Jim Davey. He's a little way back, but a man we thought might have some chance. One of the problems, of course, when the yellow flag goes out, it does allow the gaps to all be closed up. And, of course, if the car comes on halfway through the field, that does tend to split them. But that's something they have to contend with in the interests of safety. And we're back now racing. There's 408, and he seems to have got problems. That's the lead. And 95, the second place man, is the one who's put him in there. In fact, 95, David Webb from Camberley, was the chap who put him in there. But he's back and running. We'll try and pick up and see what difference that's made to the places. I think 334 has now taken it up. 95 has come back in again, but some way back. 17, Roy Eaton has moved up through in there. We're about to get to this sort of rather chaotic changing of places under these circumstances. There's 334, who we saw go through. 20, Dave. Pierce has just gone through. But 17 has now taken up the lead with 9 laps gone. 17, Roy Eaton from Reading is now the leader. Back marker number 25, Patrick Green, just backing off out of the way as two more make an excursion into the fence, including the number 80 car. But he just bounces out and get back in there. But he's not anywhere amongst the places. That's the man who was the leader a moment or two ago. He's now dropped back into second place. And I think it's now 3-5-0 that's taken it up. Jeff Olding, 3-5-0, nipped past. A lot of chopping and changing of places. No, in fact, Roy Eaton is there. There's 3-5-0. 3-5-0, Jeff Olding right on Roy Eaton's tail now. So it is 17 from 3-5-0. That's the order with 11 laps in this 40-lap race comp. 95 is third. Here comes Jeff, a blue-grey driver, but been doing very, very well indeed recently. In fact, he's currently third in the points chart in the blue-grey. One of a family of brothers, most of whom have had a crack at stock car racing in one form or another over the years. So there's Jeff, going a little bit wide there, but who can criticise when he's out there in front? Thirteen laps gone now. They come, there's 17 Roy Eaton. There's some of the cars further back. 54 Martin Brand, one of the star men. He's in about fourth or fifth place now. Dave Pierce has moved up into third in 320. 54 Martin Brand is next. Then comes 351, then 95, then 888. But it's 17, this car here, the leader. 17 Roy Eaton. 3-5-0, Jeff Olding further back, going to be under pressure in a moment or two. So there's 17, there's 3-5-0 Jeff Olding. And right behind him, we'll see that just coming in on his rear bumper now is 320 Dave Pierce. That's why Jeff was having to put some pressure on that back marker car, the 60 car just in front of him, because he could see in his mirror that the 320 car of Dave Pierce was coming up behind him. So there we are, the back marker is very much the filling in the sandwich we saw there between 350 and 320. And 17 is out, we've lost the leader. A cloud of smoke, or is it steam? I'm not sure which, coming from the back. Roy Eaton is out. So that's it. That puts 350. Jeff Olding back into the lead. A lot of chopping and changing there. 350 is the leader. 320 is in second place, Dave Pierce. Third now is 54, Martin Brand. But the scrap at the moment is going to be between this blue top driver and the reigning European champion and former world champion 320, Dave Pierce. And as we might expect, Dave fairly easily sweeps through on the inside to take it up. 320, Dave Pierce, the leader. 350, Jeff Olding in second place. 54, Martin Brand is third. There's Dave Pierce. Not only is he the European champion, but he's currently the national points champion as well. That means he scored more points so far this season than any other driver. And there's the blue top who's trying to keep up with him. Jeff Olding going well. That's the gap between the first and second. Off the bend and down that straight. Off the shale, which forms part of the speedway circuit here at Wimbledon, onto the tarmac bends used exclusively by the stock cars. There's 54. Martin Brand coming back in there in third place. He's got a little bit to do as well. Further back, 95, Dave Webb is still in the fourth place. 407, Jim Davey. Now, as I speak, in fact, Jim Davey has now moved into fourth place in 407. 95, Dave Webb has gone down to fifth. Then comes the 242 car of Brian Stacey, and behind him, 654 Gordon Street. But this is the leading group, 320 Dave Pierce. Now, beginning to open out something of a gap. Comfortably clear. And for in a moment or two, the pressure is going to be on Jeff Olding back in second place, because 54, Martin Brand is closing the gap. There's a back marker there that's now conveniently moved out of the way. But there's Martin Brand, right on his tail. This is the scrap for the second place. Jeff Olding there at the moment in 350, but the star man, Martin Brand, won't be too happy with that situation for very long. The laps are ticking away. We've got 24 laps down of the 40. And Martin Martin Brand looking all set now to try and move into second place. Dave Pearce is still comfortably clear in the lead out in front in 3:20. There he is, going well. No real opposition to him at the moment. The scrap at the moment is for this second place between these two. 4:07 and 95 are further back in the next two places. Oh, and that back marker, 4:08, went right across in front of Jeff Olding, and now he's nudging him, and that's what's taken Jeff Olding out. And of course, Martin Brand very ready to take advantage of that situation and sweep straight through. And that little bit of a bump just lost the momentum of the 350 car, and already the gap between second and third is considerable. There's the leader getting mixed up now with one or two back markers. In fact, he's just lapped 654 Gordon Street, who is back in eighth place. So the leader has now lapped every car bar the remaining cars in the first eight. Is the problem they always have now, just squeezing his way through between 6:35 Brian Jones and the other one on the outside. 3:20 Dave Pearce, then that's the lead car well clear. 54 Martin Brand is second. 3:50 Jeff Olding comes next. Then it's 4:07 Jim Davey, and then number 95 Dave Webb. That's the third place. He looked in with a good chance early on, but the performance and speed of the others. There's the second place man on the left. Martin Brand. Now the question is really, what chance has he got of catching Dave Pearce? Because Dave here in 3:20 is a long way clear. There must in fact be now about a third of a lap. There's a third of a lap between them, and Dave Pearce not getting held up too much by these back markers. He'll just pick them off one at a time. A little gentle tap on the rear bumper of Brian Stacey 242's car. 6:85 Brian Jones, a back marker there, but trying to stay up with Dave Pearce. There's that yellow top 4:08 who seems to keep managing to get in everybody's way, Derek Brundle. But he's getting on the outside of the track now to let the leaders stream through. So there we are, 3:20 Dave Pearce is still there. Still Martin Brand second in 54. Jeff Olding third in 3:50. 4:07 Jim Davey next. The new English champion won the title here at Wimbledon just a few weeks ago. But that was in the wet, and Jim Davey has a reputation for going well, particularly in the wet. Today, well, the tarmac bends are lovely and dry, and there's a lot of grip, as you can see, as Martin Brand just sidles his way around that turn. Nice control, comfortably there in the second place, but he's not really making too much impression on the leader. He runs the gauntlet of the 408 yellow top, gets past without problems. The laps now, five more to go, and it's looking very much as if the Spacey Leisure Winter National Silver Awards are going to be dominated by Dave Pearce in this car here, 3:20. Goodness knows he's already got enough trophies on his sideboard, and there's a good chance there's going to be another one there very shortly, because I can't see Martin Brand here in 54 really getting up on terms with him now. The gap is too great, and there's only three more laps left. Literally just under half a lap between first and second now. Two more laps to go for the leader. There's Dave Pearce going past the starting marshal's rostrum, getting the two laps to go signal. Well under control, a very smart car. Many years experience, superstar grade, European champion, former world champion. He's won most of the awards going in the sport. Certainly knows his way around this Wimbledon circuit. Inside this final lap now, Martin Brand is still there, comfortably back in second place, but this is the man who's going to take the checkered flag. There it is. 3:20, Dave Pearce is the winner. And 54, Martin Brand comes home second, about half a lap behind. And in third place, it's going to be 3:50, the blue top driver, Jeff Olding.